Don't stop running, Clover. We have to get away and find a place where we can make a plan.
I don't understand. How could this have happened?
We can discuss this once we find a safe place to formulate a plan of action.
Oh no, we took a wrong turn.
That's not possible. I kept track of where we've been, and this hallway should not lead into a wall.
Well, it did, so fix it.
There are doors on the opposite sides. Check that one.
It's locked.
This one as well. Blast.
We have to go back.
You might want to rethink that. I see that all too familiar glow in the distance.
Oh no.
Clover? Clover, why would you run away from me? I need my best friend back.
Without him.
Rosebud? Please, put the axe down.
I can't do that, Clover. Not with Kronos standing in the way of our friendship. You're my friend, and no one else can have you.
Clover, are you sure you want to do this?
Yeah, I'm sure, Doctor.
Clover, it's only been 1 week since Rosebud left for that resort. She may be staying longer because she's enjoying herself.
That's not like her, Doctor. She's usually prompt and always shows up for work on time. Something is not right, I can feel it.
Are you certain it's not the cold you're suffering from that you're feeling?
No.
All right. So explain to me what happened in this situation.
Well, it began when Rosebud got me to take part in this co-op opportunity.
Now remember, for ponies who are attending this co-op seminar, you get vouchers for a weekend getaway at a relaxing resort.
Rosebud, are you sure that Minotaur can be trusted?
Clover, wasn't it you who reminded me that I need to be more trusting?
Trusting, yes. Being taken advantage of is another story.
What's the big deal? Anyway, we get free vouchers for a resort, and all it's going to cost us is a couple hours of our time. Pretty sweet deal, if you ask me. And I get to have some quality time with my BFF while we're relaxing at a spa.
That does sound pretty good, if it's for real. Since I couldn't go with her, she was supposed to go there for the weekend and be back on Monday. And she hasn't come back yet.
That does seem a bit odd. She's annoying, but she's usually punctual about it.
Doctor!
Well, Clover, it looks like we've arrived. What's that, girl? It appears that there is more to this location than meets the eye. The TARDIS will need to perform some additional analysis to determine what's going on here.
You mean, there's something wrong with this place?
Not sure.
Well, I guess we'll deal with that if necessary. We have to find out what happened to Rosebud first. Doctor, did you miss the mark again?
What are you talking about?
That Minotaur said this was a resort. He didn't say anything about there being snow here.
Clover, I can assure you that we are exactly where we're supposed to be, and at the right time.
I knew there was something shady about that Minotaur.
Well, regardless, we are here. I suspect that building ahead is the resort.
Doctor, if I didn't know any better...
I'd swear this place looks awfully familiar. Nah, probably just our imagination. So, this is the Lookover Hotel and Resort. Cherry place.
Does that description include cracked windows, unkempt landscapes, rickety shutters, and peeling paint?
I guess they don't make 4-star resorts like they used to.
Doctor, they never make them like this. Something is wrong, and the sooner we find Rosebud, the better.
Yes, I agree. And we'd better get inside. This snowstorm is getting worse. Well, this confirms it. This is not a 4-star resort.
You think? What was your first clue? The dust and cobwebs all over the place? The furniture covered in sheets? The lack of bell ponies asking for our luggage? It was the last one, wasn't it? On second thought, don't answer that. Are you getting a bad feeling about this place?
No, not really.
Of course not. Doctor, did you...
It wasn't me.
Okay, this place is giving me the creeps.
Clover, think logically for a minute. This place looks run down as if it hasn't been used in months, and yet the lights still work. Doesn't that seem a bit odd?
Are you saying this place is... haunted?
Of course not. And I think you've been reading too much of those spooky fodder stories you like so much. How you find entertainment in those stories, I'll never know.
Hey!
Well, I don't want to spend any more time here than we have to. With that storm getting stronger, the temperature's going to drop significantly in here. We can cover more ground if we split up.
Right. Could we split up and I come with you, Doctor?
Are you all right, Clover? Not scared, are you?
In a word, yes, I am. Scared. Very scared.
Right. Fine. We'll go together.
Well, we covered the entire first floor and no sign of any pony. I hope Rosebud is alright.
Let's check the next floor. Good thing this building is only 2 stories.
Doctor, those creaking sounds we've been hearing throughout this hotel are not putting my mind at ease. Neither are these creaking stairs.
For a building this old, Clover, you have to expect appropriate sound effects.
Okay, this is your last chance to have a bad feeling about this place.
The halls are dimly lit, but it's enough for us to walk around without injury. Do you feel comfortable enough to split up now?
I think so, Doctor.
Good. You check this room on the left, and I'll check this room on the right.
Okay.
If you should see anything out of the ordinary, call me, Clover.
All right, Doctor.
Something is definitely off-kilter about this place. I've been in enough run-down buildings to know when something is obviously not what it seemed. This is obviously one of the guest rooms. Just about the same as all the other floors. Dust everywhere. Sheets covering the furniture. This is way too obvious.
Doctor!
What? No, Clover! Clover! What's wrong? Why did you yell out for me?
Doctor, look. The walls.
Well, it appears that the walls are leaking some kind of red substance. Its chemical makeup appears to be iron oxide hydroxide.
What?
It's rust, Clover.
Rust?
Yes, rust.
I don't think I want to. Doctor, there's a little filly out there.
What? Oh, so there is. But why is she just standing there?
Hey, are you okay? Don't be afraid, we aren't going to hurt you. Wait, come back!
Clover! Why must they continue to wander off?
Wait, where are you going? Where are the other ponies here? Come on, wait! How can she run so fast? Where did she go?
Clover, Don't run off like that. These dimly lit hallways make navigating extremely difficult as it is. So, where's that filly?
I don't know, Doctor. She ran down this hallway and I lost sight of her.
Well, she couldn't have gone very far, and there are only a few rooms down this hall, so let's look for her.
This is the last room. I hope she wasn't able to slip by us. Well, this room is empty too.
Clover?
Rosebud? Oh, Rosebud, we found you! What's wrong, Rosebud? You don't look well.
Clover! Oh, thank Celestia, you've come. What took you so long? You kept me waiting. Oh, you were right, this place is just a farce. I came here, got caught up in the blizzard, and then I couldn't leave. And the voices, they just won't stop. Listen, you can hear them. Whispering, taunting me. Oh, and the spiders. Oh, my Celestia, the spiders. They just keep coming.
Rosebud, I don't hear any whispering. What's happened to your hoof?
I sprained it, trying to run away. From them.
From them? Them who?
Shh, not so loud. They'll hear us. And then they will get us. I've been able to stay hidden, but they keep coming for me.
Who, Rosebud?
Clover, thank goodness I found you and... Oh, you found Rosebud.
What's he doing here?
Rosebud, Kronos come to help me find you.
No. He's one of them. Stand back, Clover. I'll deal with him myself.
Now, Rosebud, calm yourself. Put the axe down.
Rosebud, what are you doing?
He's one of them. I know it.
Rosebud, stop!
Clover, stand aside. No, wait. Are you really Clover?
What?
Oh, I see what's going on here. This is another one of their tricks. Well, you won't fool me this time. Oh, no. Not this time.
Rosebud, it's really me. Please calm down. What are you doing? Put that axe down.
She is possessed. Be gone, Spriggan! It usually works in the movies. Okay. Now I have a bad feeling about this. Clover, I think Plan B is in order here. Yes, I'd highly recommend it.
But Doctor, we can't just leave her!
Oh, you won't fool me again. Not this time. Oh no, Clover. See, Clover would always believe me. Unless she was tricked.
Doctor, maybe you're right.
Don't stop running, Clover. We have to get away and find a place to make a plan.
I don't understand. How could this have happened?
We can discuss this once we find a place that is safe. Huh? What?
Oh no. We took a wrong turn.
That's not possible. I kept track of where we've been, and this hallway should not lead to a dead end.
Well, it did, so fix it.
There are doors on opposite sides. Check that one.
It's locked.
This one as well. Blast. Have to use the sonic.
We have to go back.
You might want to rethink that. I see that all too familiar magical glow in the distance.
Oh, no.
You want to run away from me? I need my best friend back. Without him.
Rosebud, please listen to me. Something has affected you. Put the axe down.
I can't do that, Clover. Oh no. Not with Kronos standing between our friendship. You're my friend, Clover. And no one else can have you!
Got it! Inside, Clover! Okay, this should buy us some time.
Doctor, what is wrong with her?
There is something going on, but I'm not sure what.
She's not herself, that's for sure. She was scared!
What is it? We were here for quite some time. Why hasn't it affected us yet?
What do you mean?
Think about it. A vacant rundown resort wouldn't cause someone to react like this. Not even being stuck here for a week. No, there is something else that is causing this.
Doctor, she's right outside the door.
Oh, Clover, come out of there, or I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your door in.
Pink Doctor, what is causing this? Come on, Doctor, come on! Wait a minute. Exposure. Has to be something here she was exposed to that caused her erratic behavior.
That's all well and good, Doctor, but how does that help us?
The window. Let's use that to escape.
Doctor, the storm is as strong as ever. We'll freeze to death.
Would you rather face the raving pony with the axe?
Oh, when you put it that way. Open the window, Doctor.
Blast, it's locked.
Here's Rosebud.
Got it. Come, Clover, out the window.
Oh, okay.
I'm coming for you, Clover.
Sorry, Miss Rosebud. Mustache.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. You won't get away from me.
Clover, come to me. We must huddle together for warmth for the absolute last minute, and then we're going to head to the TARDIS.
Couldn't you just bring the TARDIS here? You know, so I don't freeze my flank off.
I want her to follow us.
What are you planning, Doctor?
Just follow me.
You come back here, Clover.
Clover, just stay close to me.
Doctor, I can barely feel my hooves.
Come on, Clover, stay with me.
I'm trying, Doctor. Cold is slowing me down.
I know. Just keep thinking about the warmth of the TARDIS.
I'm gonna get you. I wanna play with you. I'm gonna get you. I wanna be your best friend.
We are friends, Rosebud.
You're only friends.
Okay, she's scaring me. She's getting closer, Doctor.
Just keep going.
I'm trying, Doctor. That's so hard.
You're doing well, Clover. Look, there she is.
The TARDIS never looks so good.
Just a little further. Oh, girl, you never look more lovely.
What about Rosebud? She'll freeze to death.
No, she won't. She'll exhaust herself, but I will not let her freeze to death.
Oh, Clover! You come out of that box now! Clover, come on out now! Okay, Clover, come on out! Clover, please come out now! Clover, come out now.
Quick, help me get her inside.
Oh, sweet Celestia. Doctor, she's not moving.
She'll be all right. We have to warm her up slowly. Well, that should do it. This room will raise its temperature at a gradual rate so that she will warm up and recover nicely.
Oh, thanks, Celestia. But what could have caused her to go crazy like that?
The TARDIS was able to make a diagnosis of the area. Here, let me show you. Now, here is the resort and its surrounding area. Now, if we change the perspective, we get a view of the resort and the ground underneath. Now, see this brown area just below the surface?
Yes.
That is the culprit that has caused this situation. Now, according to these readings, this level is saturated with a substance known as astragalus.
What?
In other words, Clover, the air in this area is filled with the fumes of rotting loco weed.
Clunkoweed? No wonder she was acting so crazy. So, what do we do now?
We take Rosebud home. She'll be ill for a couple of days, but she will survive. After all, she will have her bestie take care of her. But still, I have to wonder, who was the mastermind behind this whole thing?
It was the Minotaur!
No, this is definitely not the Minotaur's doing.
If not him, then who?
That is a good question. Still, we made it out and found your friend in the process. That's all that matters now, Clover.
Well, that didn't turn out as we expected.
Yes, most unfortunate. This location has so much potential for experimentation and research. Should we leave this universe?
Don't be ridiculous. This planet is just a small portion of what this universe has to offer. We'll just move on to the next planet and rebuild. And if we should run into this Dr. Interloper, we will deal with him swiftly and perfectly.